Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about beef production. Of course, beef is simply the meat that comes from cows or cattle, so let's take a look how it's produced. Cattle is in the bovita family, or commonly called bovine. It contains species such as the bison, the water buffalo, and of course what we know as cattle. Fun fact, omega-3s are just one of the reasons grass-fed beef is healthier than corn-fed beef. Humans have eaten beef since prehistoric times, and there's evidence of that in the earliest known cave paintings. There are literally thousands of breeds of cattle around the world, but when it comes to beef production, Angus, Brangus, Shorthorn, Hereford, and Brahma are used very commonly, and of those, Angus is by far the most common. Fun fact, beef is more nutritionally dense than other meats, including chicken. The top three producing countries are the US, Brazil, and China. There are two main ways to raise cattle: free range or concentrated animal feeding operations, or CAFOs. Free range is exactly what it sounds like. Cattle are in a pasture and they are free to walk around and graze as they please. Fun fact, beef is a natural dietary source of vitamin B12. CAFOs are basically factory farms. The USDA defines them as an intense animal feeding operation in which over 1,000 animal units are confined for over 45 days a year. And they supply 70% of the beef in the US market. It's worth noting that a lot of free-range cattle are sent to finishing lots, which is a type of CFO, before they are sent to processing. The entire point of a finishing lot is to increase the weight of the cattle before processing. This is done by bringing feed to the cattle so they don't burn energy grazing a pasture. Fun fact, contrary to the nutcase media that would have you believe cutting beef and all meat out of your diet would eliminate greenhouse gases, the reality is all agriculture activity produces greenhouse gases. The feed is typically around 50% corn silage, or the entire plant ground up. The rest can be any number of things, including soybean, oat, barley, or even distiller's grain. Fun fact, the name Uncle Sam comes from the War of 1812, in which American soldiers received shipments of beef labeled U.S. beef. The shipments actually came from Sam Wilson, a meat packer from New York. Soldiers began calling their beef Uncle Sam's beef, and the name of the character of Uncle Sam stuck. In the feedlot, this is where steroids are often used. Since the 1950s, the FDA has approved a number of steroid hormone drugs to be used in cattle production. Trenbolone acetate is currently the only synthetic testosterone approved for growth production in cattle in the U.S. From the feedlot, the cattle are sent to the processing plant. If you're sensitive to images of meat being butchered, it's probably a good idea to turn the video off right now. The USDA inspects all cattle at processing plants in the U.S. and assigns it a grade. Fun fact, Americans eat more beef on Memorial Day than any other day of the year. The grades are, from best to worst, prime, choice, select, standard, commercial, utility, cutter, and canner. Grades are assigned mostly based on marbling, which is the white, fatty connective tissue often found within muscle tissue. Less than 2% are graded as prime. It's difficult to find in retail stores because fine restaurants and steakhouses buy up the supply. The hanging weight is the weight of the body after the head and most of the organs have been removed. It's about 60% of the total live weight. Cattle are then reduced to halves, then quarters, then primal cuts. A primal cut is the entire section of an individual steak or what retail cuts are made from. On a T-bone, one side is a New York strip and the other side is a filet mignon. What makes a porterhouse steak is it's a T-bone, but the fillet side is at least 1 1/4 inches thick, and they are derived from the rear of the short loin where the tenderloin is most abundant. This is a tenderloin. Filet mignon is cut from it. My favorite is the ribeye. It's cut from a rib roast. It can have the bone attached or removed. Note, only rib roast graded as prime are prime rib. Otherwise, it's just a rib roast. And who can forget about burgers on the grill? About half of the meat becomes ground beef. It's mostly made from the trimmings of other cuts. If you've enjoyed this video, please take a minute and subscribe, and then type "I subscribed" in the comment section below so that we can interact with you.